Hello, it's me, Devin, and I'm back. First, I want to apologize for not posting my review sooner, but I am here to review Moulin Rouge the Musical. I am very, very affected by seasonal affective disorder, or SAD, as it is called. It does not affect my mood necessarily. It affects more my energy level and my general interest and motivation to do things. However, I have been listening to the cast recording for Moulin Rouge, and I was getting all pumped up, and so I was like, you know, it's been long enough. I should just post my review. And so, here you go. First off, I want to just talk about my small gripe with the show, and that is that the movie was set in 1800s, which the musical is too, but the musical modernized it quite a bit more, and so while the movie was maybe a little suggestive at times, it was never inappropriate or raunchy. The musical took it to a new level. They kind of added some Vegas-esque type costuming and turned everything a lot more sexual, which, to be honest, I was fine with. But as many of you know, I was seeing this with my mom, and so it was very awkward, and I felt very odd sitting next to my mom. It was not necessarily a problem per se in and of itself, but it was a problem for me in the sense that I was sitting next to my mom. Anyway, now on to the actual show. I will start with the theater. The Al Hirschfeld Theater is decked out. It looks just like the photo I showed in my pre-Moulin Rouge video, in that there are chandeliers everywhere, there's fabric draped from the ceiling. It is really cool and really fancy. And the stage was extended out into the audience. So it looks more like a stage you would see at a concert than a stage you would see at a Broadway show. Now for the cast, Karen Olivo as Satine. I mentioned that I was nervous to see how she was going to be, since she is more of a belter than a soft-toned singer. She has a voice more like Beyonce, which is funny. If you've heard the song The Sparkling Diamond from the cast recording, maybe it might just be funny to me. And I will say that I was not wrong to be nervous. She did have a slightly different voice than Nicole Kidman does, but what I had to do was think of it as being a totally separate show from the movie. And once I did that, I was able to kind of let that nervousness go and enjoy the show and her performance for what it was, because she does really do a great job. And I was quite satisfied with everything she did. Danny Burstein as Harold Ziegler, kind of the MC of the show, maybe. He was very good, as usual. I had no reason to suspect he was going to be anything other than great, and he wasn't anything other than great. It wasn't a big flashy performance. It was just a good one. I was happy with it. Now on to Aaron Tveit. Oh man, he was good. His voice is perfection. And I just was so happy with his performance. I actually waited at the stage door after. I wasn't going to, because I figured there would be a lot of people, especially teenage girls, who wanted to meet Aaron, but there weren't. Let's go. So at the last minute, I decided to join the people at Stage Door and meet Aaron, and he was so nice. I cannot adequately express how happy I was that he was really nice and really grounded and really welcoming to me as a fan. I ended up tweeting something after the show and talked about him in it, and he tweeted back. It was so great and really just met all my expectations. Now, the play aspect of the musical, I was gonna say it was kind of not as good and not as well acted as the lavish and spectacular theater and song list. But on second thought, the play aspect of it was really good. It was downplayed more, but all the songs were so high energy, and the show was high emotion to where they kind of, in my opinion, balanced each other out. Some shows I leave feeling really distressed and sad and just emotional that the play is over. But this, because the songs were in stark contrast to the story, I thought it worked out better than a lot of shows, if that makes sense. So, anyway, if you want to sum up my experience at Moulin Rouge the Musical in one sentence, I will say I loved it. If the same cast is in it when I go back next year, I will probably be seeing it again, although without my mom. That is how good it is. So, thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Also, there are two cool videos of Aaron DeVait and Karen Olivo on, I think it's Stephen Colbert, talking about the show and singing one of the songs. So I will put the links somewhere. And be sure to watch them and enjoy.